I like to squeeze my chest.
I have to break my back. Pull.
Break's head. Break.
Try. You wreck my I'll be honest, bro.
It's early morning, it's like 9 a.m. right now. Today is Yom Al-Arafa, so I am fasting and I can't take any pre-workout or drink any water, so I'm kind of excited to see how this workout's gonna go. But as you guys can see, I'm a skinny little boy right now. I told you guys I'm gonna take you guys along. This is so cool, I'm like mic'd up for the first time. Stretching right now, so I don't completely wreck my Opening up my hip flexors right now. I'm so tight. I don't know if it's the fasting or if I just stepped on the wrong side of the bed. Also, side note, but when you guys do your stretching, if you keep your hands up here without holding onto your body, it helps engage your core. And that in turn kind of turns your body on, which just sounds completely bad, but kind of opens up your body and gets it ready for your compound movements. So I'm going to be starting off my back days. Usually I start them off with sumo deadlifts. I'll touch a little bit on my back workout and what my current split is in accordance to my goals. After this workout is done, I'll go more in depth on my split and what my coach has me doing. One of my favorite stretches, I think this is called like the big three, really wakes me the hell up. And I kind of like to squeeze my chest, glutes, chest and lats, glutes, cat and cow. And now you're basically injury bulletproof, ready for deadlifts. So
if you had to create a human, what would you put them through to make them tough? It wouldn't be a really chill life. What would you put them through to make them patient? You probably wouldn't give them things immediately. And so it's like, we want these traits, but each of the traits has a price tag attached to it. And it's just like, do you want to pay the price tag to get the thing? And so I think if people reframe the period of life that they're going through as the price that they're paying out of their wallet, that the wallet is their time, is the seconds of life that they're trading for it, then I think more people would be willing to make the trade. Because at least when I look at myself, when I'm 80 something years old and I'm looking back on my life, I want to have these traits. But in order to have those traits, I know I have to go through these things. And I think for me, that's given me a lot of comfort in hard times.
These are deadlift shoes, also known as lemon pepper steppers. Usually whenever I take these out, that means I'm about to lift some heavy weight, or at least what I consider to be heavy, which is around the upwards of 300, 400 pounds. This kind of helps me grip the floor. Gives me like a really close, like barefoot feeling. It's my last set. I only do two sets of deadlifts because my body takes forever to recover from deadlifts.
Nobody works like David in this house. 13, come on. 14, come on. 15, shut that muscle down. 16, come on. Get it. 17.
You don't know me, son.
Get it. 18.
You don't know me, son.
Get it. 19.
You don't know me, son.
Yeah. 20, you got
you
some more.
Me, son.
21. Yeah, get it again. Come on, we want to see it. Good. 22.
Who's going to carry the boats and the logs?
That's you, buddy. Come on, 23. Come on, 24. One more, David.
Who's
one more
to carry the boats?
All right, boys. So the workout footage was cut short because Jason had to take care of some stuff with his car, so I don't have anyone to film me. But I want to give you guys a little bit of a training update as well as what's going on for the rest of the year. So I lost 18 pounds in Ramadan. So I was 180 before Ramadan. And then after the end of Ramadan, I was at 162, 163, around there fluctuating. And believe it or not, I actually really enjoyed the fact that I lost a lot of weight in Ramadan because it showed me what my body could look like at a leaner state and not at such a bulkier state. I think one of the misconceptions that I had going into building muscle in the past was just eat as much as you can and work out as hard as you can. And those calories are going to translate into building muscle. Unfortunately, that's just simply not the case. You have to make sure that you're eating the right foods, and I just wasn't the best at doing that. So I'm really glad that I lost 18 pounds during the month of Ramadan. Right now, I weigh about 176, and I'm trying to cut back actually back to 171. I was happiest with my body when I was in the higher 160s and the lower 170s. So I think 171, 172 is my cap. Now, the goals that I have at the end of December, which is why I'm documenting these videos, is I want to be weighing 180,
but I want to be lean. So by Christmas, New Year's time, I want to be 180 pounds of lean muscle. Now I'm using this app called MacroFactor to track all of my calories, my protein, my fats, and my carbohydrates. This isn't sponsored by any way, shape, or form by MacroFactor, but it's the app that I use to track all of my macros when doing my meals. It's really convenient because you plug in your body fat, you plug in your activity, you plug in how active you are during the days, you plug in how many times you go to the gym and all your goals, and then according to like the AI software system, they'll come up with a whole concoction of what your plan is going to be in order to set your goals. So according to that, I have to gain between, I think it's 1/4 pound or 1/2 pound every single week to reach my goals, my goal target by the end of the month, by the end of the year, sorry. So it's already the month of June. By the time I'm filming this, it'll probably be July. So we only have 6 months of the year left. So inshallah. So now the split that I'm currently running is 4 days are going to be weights, 2 days are going to be boxing and conditioning. This is to help my body not overtrain, because I tend to overtrain a lot and not let my body recover properly. And then my hormone levels are just so out of whack. But basically I do push, pull, legs. So on Monday, I'll do chest, triceps, and shoulders. Tuesday, I'll do back and biceps. Wednesday, I'll do legs. And then Thursday is a boxing day. Friday is an upper body day. And then Saturday is kind of more like an active recovery, light, like boxing slash, I'll hit the bag a little bit for a couple of rounds. That's kind of what I got going for my body right now. I noticed it's a lot more enjoyable for me to have less sets, less reps for my bodybuilding days than having, for example, 4 sets of 12. My body likes it a lot better when I have 3 sets of 6 or 3 sets of maybe even 4 sets of 6, you know. But when I have lower sets and lower rep ranges, my body just recovers better. I'm able to contract the muscle a lot harder and just grow a lot better that way. I don't want to be the strongest, nor do I want to be the biggest. I just want to be able to move as best as I can and have a decent amount of muscle in my body, because that's just the most practical in my opinion. There's this misconception in the fitness industry that if you want to gain a lot of muscle, then you should train 6-7 days, almost every single day of the week, which is just not right. If you guys are watching this and you're a beginner, for most of you guys, because I know a lot of you guys do want to start going to the gym, start with a 3-day-a-week full body program. So Monday, Wednesday, Friday, or Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday, go 3 days a week, start with a full body routine. You know, work on your compound lifts, focus on your squat and your bench form and your technique. Just focus on really getting the fundamentals down, because that's what's going to really help you progress in the long term. When your body plateaus and you're not making progress after maybe a couple of months running the 3-day-a-week program, then you can switch it up to 4, and your body requires more intensity and your body requires more frequency in the training in order for you to grow. I hope that makes sense. Because, I mean, I'll be honest, boys, it's 2023. It's about time that you need to get your body bigger. You need to get your fitness in check. There's no excuse for you to be skinny. There's no excuse for you to be fat. Everyone is working hard towards their goals, and you should be too. I remember when I first started fitness, I was 127 pounds, and I got up to 180 pounds in a matter of 6 months. And my strength went from being able to squat the bar and bench the bar, and my squat went up to 345, my deadlift went up to 445, and my bench was at like 205. And this was all done in the matter of 6 months. So I went from like a skinny, scrawny kid to a kid that had a good bit of muscle. Now, although lifting heavy isn't my goals right now, but I think when you do start working out, strength should be one of the main areas that you're focusing heavy on. Going to pack my bags right now, headed for Louisiana, and then we're going to grab a bite to eat. We got to pick up Rhythm first also, because he's also fasting. I have to break my fast at the airport. I've never done that before, so I'm excited to do that for the first time. Two thobes, one for Eid, another one for casual wear. Gotta spice things up a little bit, you know? I've been contemplating all my time. You've been in. My thoughts make me tired, just running through my mind. Wonder if there's peace that I can find. Instead of always being on. The only place that I'm confident in vlogging is the bathroom, and there's absolutely no one except for me. And little man, we made it back to New Orleans, old stomping grounds, alhamdulillah. I'm here really ready to see my parents and my family, spend a week with them, inshallah. I'm going to miss everyone in Dallas, but I
I've been looking forward to this trip for a while.
Eid Mubarak.
Assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu alaikum. Eid Mubarak.
Eid Mubarak.
We wish you were here. We wish you were here, man. What is it called? Hope you guys are doing well and your Eid is going good. Me and Baba just finished Eid Salah. And, you know, as the usual, Baba is giving salam to everyone in the community along with me.
Assalamu alaikum, beta.
Yeah.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless with your family, beta. And then have a very special good Eid, beta.
Amen. Okay? Amen.
Just enjoy and we miss you so much, beta, here. But inshallah, we'll be together in
the... I forgot to show him the Eid outfit. This is my Eid outfit. Me and Baba. This was from Shukr. Junaid gave it to me.
Junaid gave it to me.
Me and Baba are matching, both wearing beige. It's good seeing the community, man. Like every single Eid. See the people that you grew up with. All the beautiful faces.
They just like to see you, but I, that's what I just want you to be here. Especially this occasion.
It's crazy because you see all the Ammus and the uncles get old. Yeah. And they see you kind of grow older.